think everybody is aware of the danger that so many emergency responders put their own lives in to save other people's lives. They're often the first ones on the scene. They are parked right alongside the vehicle that's involved in the accident. They then get exposed themselves.
We're here to showcase some of the benefits of connected vehicle technology, specifically for emergency responders. We have connected vehicle equipment integrated into two representative civilian or passenger vehicles. We're also going to integrate equipment into an emergency responder vehicle. We have an ambulance out here today. We're going to set up an incident scene where the vehicles and the ambulance will be approaching. The ambulance is going to be broadcasting information about its position, its speed, its orientation. So you're going to get a visual display and an audible notification that there is an emergency vehicle coming up ahead to give you time to again, look in the rearview mirror to see what's happening, to pull over, to allow those emergency responders to get to that incident scene faster and hopefully have that extra amount of time to save the person that was involved in that incident if necessary.
Ambulance A3 responding.
And an emergency response, every second counts. Every second counts when you're injured and you need to get a treatment, when we're trying to get the traffic cleared. And every second counts when we're trying to make sure that the backups behind gets cleared as quickly as possible. Any tool that we can improve response time and safety of every single person on our transportation network is a good thing. We are always working toward zero deaths on our roadways, zero fatal accidents. And I really feel that connected and autonomous technology is the way we are going to get as close to that number as possible.
What I'm going to do is demonstrate a crash scene that I'm going to be approaching. I'll approach this crash scene on cruise control at too fast a speed by which I can avoid the emergency responders. So here we go. Set it on cruise control, and then I'll simulate coming into this crash zone with no warning. And now I'm seeing a crash zone for the first time right here, and I can't avoid fast enough. I can't get out of the way. Unfortunately, that emergency responder had a bad day. Now we'll try the same thing again using the advanced warning. My cruise control will automatically be cut off from the emergency responder's vehicle or a piece of infrastructure such as a beacon that could be carried with the emergency responder. Same speed, same conditions, and there I get a warning right there, and that's slowing me down well before I get to the problem of having to avoid this responder, and there I missed him without any problem whatsoever.
On our roads, just last year, we lost 1,200 people. And that's not to mention the thousands of accidents that we have, where people are injured and are dealing with those injuries and recovery every day for the rest of their lives. And our mission is to make sure that everybody can get home safely to their families.